Good evening and welcome. It's so great to see you all here. Tonight's program is called Symphonic Fusion, so we're melting together a variety of ideas and composers. Our first composer tonight is Maria Newman, and I have the great pleasure of being friends with Maria. She comes from the Newman dynasty of movie composers down in LA. In her bio, which you'll see in your programs, I feel like the reviewers capture her spirit. She is fun, she is feisty, and she's fierce, and an amazing person to collaborate with. This piece for her was inspired by the idea of Vivaldi. Now, it does not sound anything like Vivaldi, but it's her idea as though if a movie composer was to write something like that. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Welcome everyone. My name is Eileen and I'm a sophomore double major in music and Latino studies. This piece that we're about to play is Shostakovich's Piano Concerto No. 2. Jack Koontz won the concerto aria competition last year with this piece. If you know anything about Shostakovich, you know his music is generally sad, but this piece stands apart from the rest of his compositions as a happy piece, which he wrote for his son's 19th birthday. This piece begins with a march on bassoon, which is joined by clarinets and oboes. Then, Jack will join on piano and the piece will come alive. My favorite part is when the orchestra goes quiet and Jack has a passage of modulating sound that intensifies and is really fun to listen to. I invite you to listen to all of the exciting, exhilarating parts of this piece. It is definitely one that will keep you on your toes. Let's please welcome piano soloist Jack Koontz.
Thank you. My name is Ruby, and I play the violin with the orchestra. The next piece that we'll be playing is Brahms Symphony No. 4. As you all hopefully know from the program, the theme for this concert is symphonic fusion, which for this piece means fusion of the heart and mind. Brahms really valued the work of composers before his time, such as Beethoven, and cared a lot about preserving and advancing the craft of symphony composition. Stemming from this dedication is an enormously complex symphony full of contradicting rhythms and hidden melodies. Brahms' work is so dense and precise that I see it as almost mathematical, coming from a focused and honed mind. However, there is also a component of the heart. Brahms' melodies are emotional and lyrical in ways that you maybe wouldn't expect from such a complex piece. Some of the melodies are beautiful and remind me of how happy I am to be playing with such wonderful people in my orchestra. Others evoke a more intense sadness, reflective of Brahms' influences at the time. So, this is almost like one of those choose-your-own-adventure books. If you'd like to connect with your heart, I encourage you to think of the people close to you while you're listening. If you'd like to engage your brain, you can listen to the fourth movement, where one melody is repeated with variation 32 times. You'll get lots of time to catch it, so don't worry. I really hope you enjoy our performance, and thank you for coming.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.